alone this Thanksgiving.
He always has friends around him.
Invisible friends that are talking to him at all times. Welcome back to Metal, everybody.
Football League contest is scheduled for football. Introducing first, weighing 306 pounds, Finian. His opponent from Cleveland, Ohio, weighing 230 pounds, Lou Marconi.
We'll see if Lou Marconi can mount a challenge to the bizarre Midian. Certainly, this week in the World Wrestling Federation, taking a bizarre turn of events for Vince McMahon and his rivalry with Triple H, Tom.
This thing is really heating up. Triple H and DX are doing everything they can to make Vince McMahon's life a living hell.
Vince McMahon spent time in a jail cell this past Monday on Raw, but from his jail cell, we'll explain how Vince got into jail in just a little bit, and we'll explain what he did while he was in jail, as well as what he did when he got out a little later on, as Lou Marconi attempting to start very quickly, but Midian, of course, with more experience, able to turn things around right away.
Midian obviously had a nice Thanksgiving dinner.
Why would you say that?
Well, look at him. I mean, his tights look like they're fitting a little tighter.
As they are on all of us.
Yeah.
It's kind of the good thing about Thanksgiving.
Wow.
Backbreaker there on Lou Marconi. Very close to the ropes, and Marconi able to reach an arm out.
Midian was just covering his legs.
Midian is bizarre.
Yes, he is.
Let's go back to Raw this past Monday, Tom, and get into the whole story of Vince McMahon. I mean, certainly a man that had been pushed to the emotional breaking point by DX the week before with the constant attacks on his family. It appeared as if Vince finally snapped once and for all.
Well, we saw last week on Raw what Vince McMahon is capable of doing. And then, of course, the accusations flew after he ran this car into the limousine of DX, got out with that baseball bat, and totally destroyed the limousine.
Well, can you blame Vince McMahon? I mean, look at everything that DX had done, apparently, to family members. Shane and Stephanie, future son-in-law test.
Everybody has their breaking point, and obviously Triple H found Vince McMahon's.
Slugfest here in the ring. Marconi doing his best to hang with Midian. But then DX called the cops. They had Vince McMahon arrested, Tom.
Hey, maybe that was the best thing that could happen to him.
Best thing that could happen to Vince?
Where's all protection? I mean, if he would have gone off any farther, who knows what could have happened? I mean, somebody could have got seriously hurt.
Well, you raise a very good point. Vince McMahon, you could tell, was really at the emotional breaking point last Monday on Raw. And maybe some time in the cooler did some cooling off. But from his jail cell, not only did he make matches for later on that night on Raw, Tom, but he also accepted Triple H's challenge for Armageddon for Vince and Triple H to meet one-on-one December 12th.
Again, being emotionally charged as he was, I don't believe Vince McMahon is thinking clearly right now, but at the same time, he's not going to let anybody walk on him or his family.
And certainly it was a very focused and determined Vince McMahon that returned after making bail to the arena. Vince had ordered Triple H to meet the Acolytes in a handicap match. Triple H somehow escaped that one, but did not escape the steel chair of Vince McMahon.
Vince McMahon, again, is not going to let Triple H or DX try and run roughshod over the World Wrestling Federation as they have. Vince has lost it, in my opinion, and I think that Triple H, whether it's going to be on Vince's best behalf or not, going into Armageddon, Triple H had better watch his back.
Let's see if Lou Marconi can pull Midian over for the sunset. Oh, he can. Boy, referee Tim Whitehan was ready to come down for that third time. And you can see Midian slightly embarrassed by that, comes firing out of the blocks with a clothesline. Now, of course, as we all saw as Raw went off the air, Vince McMahon, the steel chair, then launched Triple H off the stage down into a tech area. And thankfully, Triple H not seriously injured in that fall.
You could take a look at Vince's eyes. You could see the blackness in it. You could see his eyes roll back. He wasn't even home. He just had revenge on his mind.
So then on Thursday on SmackDown, Tom, we're all enjoying a Thanksgiving feast later on in the night. But it was not a good evening for DX as they served Vince McMahon with a temporary restraining order, basically to protect Triple H, I think, from what certainly would be more Vince McMahon-led attacks.
Well, then again, it could be in protection of Vince McMahon as well to stay 50 feet away from DX. We don't know the extent that DX will go to protect each other. But I think we're finding out.
Well, then DX, of course, just set out to humiliate some local homeless people. I mean, it's so unfortunate that these people in their plight to begin with, and this in the season of giving and being thankful, that degenerates as they are would try to really take advantage of the homeless.
Well, they might have taken advantage earlier in the night of the homeless, but later on, they got their feast.
They certainly did. And as we all saw at SmackDown, that was a food fight for the ages. I don't think we'll ever see anything like that quite again here in the World Wrestling Federation. But maybe, Tom, it's a new Thanksgiving tradition.
I like that.
Just like, of course, the annual Gravy Bowl match, which we saw on SmackDown this Thursday.
What a Gravy Bowl match that was, too. I mean, the golden ladle, it was great.
Lou Marconi somehow able to mount an offense after absorbing a tremendous amount of punishment from Midian, but now runs into the boot. And look at this now. Sets and delivers.
Oh!
Calls that the H-bomb. Hook of the leg, two, and this one is over.
Marconi won't be getting up after that one.
Midian!
So Midian is victorious on this Thanksgiving weekend edition of Metal. Later on in the hour, D'Lo Brown to go one-on-one against Sean Stasiak. But the world is talking about the wedding this Monday, live on Raw. We'll see it. Test marrying Stephanie McMahon.